Good morning, King's Academy in West Palm Beach. I'm Garrett Weisberg.
And I'm Stenton Kwai, and you're watching King's TV.
Before we get into our news this week, let's just take a moment to acknowledge a sad moment from our nation's history.
19 years ago today, the World Trade Center was destroyed in one of the U.S.'s worst terrorist attacks.
Hi, I'm Ryan Cavanaugh. Back in last school year, in February, we visited the 9/11 Memorial in New York on our NYC trip. I thought it was a really unique experience to walk through the 9/11 Memorial. I definitely take it for granted. I mean, I wasn't alive during that time, but to see all the pictures of all the people and to see some of the remnants was a really cool experience, but also makes you think a lot about it and definitely makes you feel somewhat sad and solemn.
Students, on this Memorial Day, as we look back on 9/11 and we're reminded of those who gave their lives for others, I'm reminded of Jesus' words, who tells us that there's no greater love than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. And we truly do remember those who gave their lives for us and for others. And so let's pray and give God thanks for them. Father, we're so thankful for the men and women who gave their lives 19 years ago to save others, and to many others who have given their lives to give us freedom here in the United States of America. Lord, we're thankful, and we're also thankful for you, Father, who gave your son, Jesus, sacrificed his life on the cross so that we could have freedom from our sin and from death. And Lord, we're just grateful. We're grateful for the men and women, and we're grateful for you, Lord. Help us to remember them on this day. And we pray in Christ's name, amen.
I hope everyone will take the time today to remember those who lost their lives 19 years ago.
On a brighter note, earlier this week, our Kings volleyball team swept Newman 3-0 in their first game of the season. Great job, Lady Lions. We can't wait to see your progress throughout the season.
Speaking of sports, Lions football kicks off tonight in their first game against Lemon Bay.
To take an inside look, here's Trevor Snyder with head coach Keith Allen.
You step on the field, I don't care if we're up 50-0. I don't care if we're down. I don't care whatever the situation is. You are a starter for the Kings Academy football team. You understand that?
Hey, lines on three, lines on three. One, two, three.
Lines!
Biggest thing it means to play TKA football is brotherhood. It's a bunch of guys scrapping together and playing for the guy next to him, to the left and the right. It's not about the people in the stands. It's not about the limelight. It's not about the recruiting. It's about the guy next to you. What it means to play TKA football, in one word, is brotherhood.
While students won't be able to attend the games in person yet, our digital arts team will be broadcasting the game live. Some of the changes include more camera angles, on-field reporting, live commentating, and post-game interviews with the players and coaches. So make sure to tune in at 6:45 tonight.
Being an exchange student must have been tough over the summer with all the COVID restrictions and travel bans. So here's Ryan Cavanaugh with Sirma Amos to tell us more about how his summer went.
I'm Sirma Amos. I'm from Kenya. I've been here for 8 months. I first came in last year during the summer for like a soccer camp. That's how I met the King's Academy. It took some time to convince my parents to come here. So my mom, after she heard it's a Christ-based school, she loved it, and she couldn't say no from there. With COVID-19, it's been pretty hard. I was really hoping to meet my parents during the summer and my friends, but Luckily, I was with my uncle in Daytona Beach, so it wasn't as much as fun as being with my family, my sister, my brother, my friends, so it's been hard. When I go home, I'm gonna be excited to see my family at first, but mostly my friends, because they are different from my friends here, because we've been with them like for 6 years, so they really know me, so it will be fun. Plus, talking in American English, it's gonna be funny for them, so it's gonna be some experience, mostly with my friends.
Thank you, Ryan, for that interesting segment.
Before we go, students, make sure to check out Group 316. Group 316 is a Bible study that meets at the picnic tables by the football field every Wednesday. They meet during lunch A, B, and C. So make sure to go check it out.
That concludes all our announcements for this week. This has been Stenton Quay.
And Garrett Weisberg, and you've been watching Kings TV. So make sure to tune in at 6:45.
They made me laugh.